Okay. Hey guys, Shadow someone here, and today we're playing Minecraft on the PS4. We did take delivery of a new PS4 last night. We got it set up about an hour ago, and finally finished up this new house. And I'm gonna go ahead and give you guys a brief in-depth tour of the house. Here, same city as the old house, as you can see here. I'm in creative mode right now. I used it to build the house. I forgot to switch over. The old house is right here still, right next to the interstate here in Reidsville, and still got my truck out front, or mule if you want to be specific, my Ram 2500 Longhorn. So I have yet to pave a road over here, but I watched a tutorial. I don't remember the channel. I would mention it if I could remember it. It's been a few weeks since I did this, but this is actually my new house here on 94 Nirvana Drive in Reidsville, North Carolina. 94 is my old football number. So we're gonna come on in. As you can see, it is a two-story house. I haven't decided yet if I'm gonna actually finish and make that look a bit more professional. But first, let's start over here. In this first room is the kitchen. You know, it's gonna have the furnace, the crafting table, and this chest here for cooking supplies and food and all that stuff. And then over here is the main storage room. This I might convert over to a standard run-of-the-mill room in the near future, but that's not, I haven't decided on that yet. So we're gonna go ahead and head up to level 2, as you can see by that sign. And on level 2, you have my room, like right in your face, and then it's just a bed. Over here is weapon storage, just got a box. It's just gonna have weapons in it, nothing major. Just gonna hop on over here to the guest room, which is right here, empty right now. And then again, I haven't really finished this off yet. So yeah, let's go ahead and head on down, unless it's nighttime, and we're gonna go back up then, since it's nighttime. And then I'm gonna go show you guys the new garage, and then we're gonna start getting things moved over from the old house, as well as getting the new roof painted. And I apologize for my voice right now. I was over at my brother's football game yelling and screaming, mainly at the refs. So I'm a little hoarse right now. Alright, that might have helped a little bit. I just drink a little bit of water. I know it's been about a week since I last uploaded anything gaming related, and I apologize for those that have been waiting for, especially this series right here, to come back, and all that good stuff. So let's go ahead, and since I've given you now the in-depth tour of the house, and that's subject to change. You know, it's not finished yet. I actually just finished building the entire house this morning. Or not this morning, but this afternoon. This side was already finished. This porch wasn't on here yet, but everything else was. And this side was finished. As well, as you can see, part of that room blocks out the window. So the back, I did myself. I didn't bother copying and pasting it. But like I did over here on this side, I did put the windows up. This I built this morning. This second top half, I guess you could say. So, yeah, let's move over here to J1 Customs. This is basically like you would find, like, Pimp My Ride and stuff, that one garage they went to. And, of course, my personal vehicles will be stored in the back. Of course, I've only got the truck right now, but I am planning on taking delivery of a horse soon, in which, in my world, will be referred to as a Ferrari FF, because that is probably one of my favorite cars right now. Not my dream car by any means, but you know, I love that car. So we're gonna make the roads out of gravel instead of cobblestone, and I hate gravel to death, but it works the best right now for this area, especially because this isn't even an actual road really. So we're just gonna build it off of over here. So we're gonna start the construction of the road. We're gonna kind of add a turning lane in to make it seem a bit more official. Oops, still fudged up. Okay, there we go. I'm just gonna hover. It makes things go by a lot quicker. Just gonna go ahead and cut. Dig. So we got our gravel, merge it back with the main road, and then we're going to continue on. Alright. Now, I know this construction stuff is probably not the greatest thing to watch, and I know it's relatively boring to some viewers, and I know, I'm sorry. I do plan on doing some fun stuff later on in the year, going through the Nether, just messing around, all that garbage. Alright, so we've reached the house for the most part. I'm just gonna go ahead and just stop the road there, right there. And then I'm gonna build a side road here to lead over to the J1 Customs. Right? I know what you're gonna say, you didn't really finish this in survival, so it's not fun. But this is the same world. Only reason I went in the creative mode is it made it a lot easier for me to do because it did take a while to get this done, especially with the house itself. So, yep, there's J1 Customs now finished. The house is now finished. So let's go ahead and get started on moving stuff over. Let me just cut down this tree real quick to try to make the road a bit wider so I can get through here with the truck. And when I take delivery of the FF, get it here as well. I'll probably do a separate video when I'm taking delivery of the FF in this game, so yeah. I don't know why I'm cutting this tree down. This tree isn't blocking up the road any. It's that one I needed to cut down. I'm just being stupid for the day. Alright, so that one's cut down. I'm gonna cut this one down. And that's finished. Now I just gotta cut this last one right here. Alright, so that's all the stuff from the paving the road and stuff. We're gonna go ahead and cut, or not cut, but break that sign there. And we're gonna load up the truck first. We're gonna go ahead and clear out. I'm gonna go ahead and break these because I'm not gonna need them. Go ahead and clear that. Alright, so I'm gonna grab all these music discs. These are probably gonna be loaded into the truck originally. Break the music box and the anvil. I'm gonna break this because these are all stuff I'm not gonna need in the near future. I'm gonna break that. Alright, so now we've got the full inventory here. We're gonna go ahead and go load up the truck. Or mule, if you want to be specific, because people are like that. Alright, we're gonna load the music discs into the truck. Alright, so we're just gonna go ahead and hop out. The music discs and stuff are gonna go in the main storage room because those aren't weapons or anything dangerous that I can use. So those are just gonna get put in the main storage area. Alright, so back to this crate here, or chest, or whatever you want to call it. I am actually picking up a few weapons on the way, so I can just start on that. Alright, so we've got our first load ready to roll. I'm gonna go ahead and switch the swords or not so I don't break anything. So I've done that before. I hate doing it. Alright, so we're gonna open up the gates, hop in the truck, and we're gonna drive up on Nirvana Drive up to the new house here in Reidsville. If I could get out of my driveway. Alright. So into the turn lane and onto Nirvana Drive. Looks like for the most part that road got cleared up from where I was in here a minute ago. Clearing and then got all these oak wood saplings and I go ahead and turn down to the custom building here in J1 Customs and just drive on in. Alright, so the truck and later on the FF will be stored back here. I'm gonna go ahead and go drop off what I've got already with me and then come back for the truck. So of course, we're going to be putting stuff in the main storage area. Anything not weapon related is going here. This, I'm going to need that. That'll go in weapon storage. Nope, that's not weapons. Not weapons. Need discs. food I'm gonna put in my kitchen one. So I'm gonna need these. Those are weapons. That's food. Okay, so we got all that. Let's go ahead and come in here and drop off the food supplies, including the rotten flesh, and then the rest of these are going to go in weapons. I'm going to keep the map with me. Alright, weapon storage room. I'm going to drop these off in here. I'm going to put the armor back in the main storage room, just to make things a bit easier. I'm going to go back to that crate I was already working on. Alright. So now let's head back to the truck and pick up what we put in there. This is basically all music discs, including the infamous Music Disc 11. Alright. Back to the house. And back to that first crate or chest or whatever you want to call it. Alright, so that is our first trip to and from the new house, to and from the old house. So we're going to head back down there to pick up some more stuff. I'm going to go ahead and talk for a minute or so. With the new PlayStation being here finally, we are going to be ordering Grand Theft Auto 5. Wow, we've already got that. Grand Theft Auto 5 for the PS4 here soon. The Enhanced Edition, of course. That was made available only for PS4 and Xbox One. And with that, we're going to be getting all sorts of new goodies and stuff. You know, with the game. We did get The Last of Us with this new PlayStation. Which is quite handy because it's going to give us an extra game that we didn't really know. That we don't really know about. I don't have a clue about that game, so I'm kind of going into this blind. Wow, there's only a chest left. Alright, let's pick that up. Alright, so my inventory's empty. Right. Anyway, back to what I was saying. We got Last of Us with the system, and I'll have to input the voucher code for that after I film here. And then I got a game called, what was it, Clanked or something like that? I don't know. Some game I've never heard of, but yeah, I'll do videos on those possibly in the near future once I figure out if I want to play The Last of Us. I've heard a lot of good things about it, but I haven't really gotten a shot at it, so I guess I'll probably see about that later on when I actually get a chance to sit down and play it. But besides that, I don't really have any plans on doing videos on it. But yeah, Pokemon Oras Untamed, as I mentioned in the latest either news and announcements or update video, one of the two, that will be starting soon, and I'm very excited. I'm waiting basically on the new event for the Shiny Legendaries to come out first, and then I might start the filming for that, but I haven't made any decisions yet. Alright, so go ahead and drop those off. The anvil, I'm gonna need that. I'll put that in the main storage room as well. Like right here. We're gonna go up to level 2 and put the sword, crossbow, and the pickaxe in the weapon storage. Low swords, and then gonna move my map out of that, and then clear that so I don't have an extra anvil. So as you can see, I've explored the entire map, and that's why I decided to settle Reedsville right here. The entire state of North Carolina right here is because nice space, you know. There's a lot of wide open territory out here. Reedsville is probably one of the bigger cities I've made in this world for North Carolina. But it is really nice, and I enjoy it. Alright, after this, I'll go to the bed and set it up for the next Minecraft day, and we can continue working. Now again, with my voice, I apologize, because I do sound pretty monotone and pretty boring. I sound like that guy from The Office, I think was the movie it was called. And, yeah, so I know I'm very hoarse sounding right now, but once my voice returns to normal and I recover, I'll be fine, you know? So, I'm gonna start with the second box. We're gonna head up to the bed and go to bed. Go home, go to bed, you know? Whew. I'm very tired as well, so that's kind of explaining why I've been taking such breaks for a minute. Stuff. Alright, so one disadvantage with this house is with these torches that you can kind of see into each other's rooms. So luckily there is no getting dressed mod in this game, or else you'd be seeing nude pixelated blocks, I guess. Yeah, that was kind of TMI, so probably not going to mention that again. But yeah. Some other stuff I want to talk about real quick. I am looking into buying a capture card. I'm trying to decide between saving up and getting an Elgato HD60 1080p or whatever it's called, or getting a XSplit, because I already have the XSplit software on my computer, so I was just like, might as well, man. I mean, I already have the software, but at the same time, I like having the best I can get. So the option's open to one of those two. Haven't really made my decision yet. I know I want to get some input, so if you have one of the two, crap, left the truck over in the house, let me know, because I would love to hear about which one you prefer, if you have one or the other, the reasons why I should get which one, you know, because I am having a hard time deciding between the two. I'm also looking for possibly getting my computer boosted. When I say boosted, I mean like upgraded with better hardware, and making it stronger, basically. Because I do want to have one of the fastest computers that I can work with, so I can really make a living off of YouTube, you know? Alright, so we're going to go up here to the weapon storage. This time I've only got two things to drop off, the sword and the arrows. Okay, I'm back. Sorry, my dad needed me for something real quick, so I'm back. Now, that sounded so out of context, but anyway, forgot what I'm doing. Kind of remember, so let's go back to the old house and move the last little bit of stuff left. I'm just gonna go ahead and destroy the bedroom I've already got here at this house. Yeah, a lot of stuff. Holy crap, this is gonna be a lot of stuff. This might be two trips worth. Alright. While the new house is much bigger in height and with availability of rooms, I don't think it beats it in overall dimensions, because this is a very small house when it comes to length compared to the other one. There are some advantages to that, but not a lot. Move on to the next box. Probably gonna come back through here later and get all the food and stuff and moving on over. As you can see off in the distance, the South Carolina Clemson Stadium, Reidsville city's built kind of like right on the border. It's like a border town, basically. Any farther out west and you'd be farther south or southwest, I guess, you'd be passing right through Clemson. So kind of wish I did bring the truck back, but I keep forgetting to, because I'm a nut job like that. Well, there's a lot of stuff. Okay. If I did sell this house though, emeralds being the natural currency in this world, this house would go up for probably around a million emeralds, which is unprecedented in this world because no other house in this world has gone up for that much. And that would be like a whole new level. Alright, so now this time I am actually going to bring the truck back. So I'm going to go ahead and unlock the J1 Customs building. Personal vehicles out and take the truck over. Or mule. So I can't have much fun. But anyway, gonna go ahead and pull on into the driveway here. Make sure that's okay, it's empty. And I'm gonna shut one gate and make it quick and easy. We literally got two boxes left, and I believe this one is totally this full. And all that's left in here is a painting. So we're gonna go ahead and break that one. And then blaze rods, stuff, lots of stuff. It'll probably be pretty useless. I wonder why I've got cave spider eggs, spawn eggs things. I don't know. Then I gotta move Onyx and Jeff. I'm not making them their own doghouse. I'm just gonna move whatever's in the bottom rows. So let's go ahead and head on over. Now we've got another load. Really winding road. I'm gonna start with the stuff I've already got in my inventory. David Blaine just walked right on through the door. Alright. By far, sending my enchanted thing, bow, to the weapon storage. I'm gonna need that. That's like my favorite weapon. So I can just snipe at that thing. Alright. So we got glowstone dust. I don't know how I got that. I haven't been to the Nether lately. Alright, just gonna go ahead and throw this on. Truck for what I think is one of our last runs to the house. I'm gonna just destroy the bedroom. I really wish I could have made this road a bit straighter. So that's it for that. With the house here, I'm gonna go ahead and break that, and break these as well. Alright, so this house is officially for sale, I guess. I'm gonna move my doggies, Onyx and Jeff. Holy crap, there's a cow, two cows. Breaking into the house here, so I'm just gonna go ahead and make my doggy slaughter them. Get that sheep though. Oh, there's a fellow wolf here. So I'm gonna go ahead and shut that door. Gonna go ahead and my doggies follow me over here. Come on. And that's Let's watch. These dogs are going to get all sidetracked by that sheep right there. Or not. Alright, so they're coming inside the house. They're coming way in here. Alright, so Jeff came in, and Anna's just magically vanished in the thin air. There he is. Alright, so let's see. Where do I want them at? I guess I'll keep them in the storage room. Perfect. Alright, let's go ahead and push you in here. You'll be my guard dog. Many of you remember Onyx and Jeff back from the some of the older ones when I still lived in London in this world. But they've moved with me since. Jeff is new to the party. I got him back at the old house in Indianapolis. The second house I had in Indianapolis. So, alright, we're going to move stuff into this box now, the last of it. There's that. That's a little sheep spotted. Got all sorts of weird stuff I'm noticing. Alright, that box is full. Alright, so that is the last of the stuff we're bringing over. Now I just gotta go hit the truck again, but I'm gonna go ahead and speed it up things and go in the daytime. Alright, so there's that. We're gonna jump down from here. There's a pig outside of my house for whatever reason. He's just like sat trapped. I don't know what the hell it is. So let's go and punch him. Surprised my dogs haven't been in there yet. Nope, they're still sitting. We're gonna just punch the crap out of that pig. Alright, so this house basically cleared out now. If you're gonna play in my world, it is now available for sale basically now. And you can buy it. That house is going to be worth a lot since it's got the iron fence and the actual carpet floors and all that garbage. It's probably worth a few hundred thousand emeralds. Go ahead and pull the truck all in to the J1 Customs. And that is the ball game. Alright, so thank you guys so much for watching this J1 video. Thank you guys for the support you've given me over the last few months, and for the more subscribers and all that fun stuff. So again, like and subscribe for more from the channel, and I'll see you guys again next time. Cold blood dripping. Death on a door. The color of